So I think there are a lot of myths with taking care of patients who have diabetes and diabetic macular edema. The first is that I think we realize is that angiography is probably the gold standard still for determining retinopathy. We haven't got as good as we could with OCTA and looking at wide field imaging and wide field impact. What we realize is that there are a lot of non-perfusion that we don't necessarily see on clinical examination. And that non-perfusion can also mask neovascularization. So I think the first myth is that ultra-wide field imaging can be really quite helpful at looking at patients, and just don't discount the patient because they have no evidence of proliferative disease. The second is that we see that a persistent fluid in patients with DME, and whether that early treatment in those patients really makes a difference. The Protocol V study came out recently and showed that even patients with good vision, 20/25 or even better, that there was no impact on the final visual outcome by treating patients early versus waiting for them to decline and then treating them. So I think the thing to think about there is, and again, anatomy doesn't always correlate with the vision in those patients, and certainly didn't have an impact on that. And the last piece is just around the surveillance of patients and the treatment of retinopathy. We see patients who have a nice impact as far as retinopathy improvements, though I don't think it's hit clinical practices right now. I think there's a lot of barriers to treating retinopathy in current clinical practice. More research needs to be done to help alleviate those barriers so our patients can get treated for retinopathy over time.